Hi, and welcome to Accounting Academy. I'm Fitz, and this is my dog, Fifo. We love to help people learn more about accounting, so join us on our adventures as we dive into accounting topics. On today's adventure, we are helping our friend Ethan and Lisa. They need help creating financial statements for their new business and don't know where to start, so let's go. Hey guys, how's business?
Hey Fitz.
Hey Fitz.
Hey Fifo.
Fitz, we need your help.
Sure. What seems to be the issue?
Ethan's dad gave us money to start the lemonade business, but he made us promise to give him weekly financial statements.
He's an accountant.
I'm sure he thinks it's a good learning experience. So what seems to be the problem?
What are financial statements?
No problem. We can start with the basics, and then I'll even help you create your first financial statements.
Great!
Okay, well, let's start with what are financial statements. The financial statements are a record of financial activities and positions of an entity that help make it easy for readers of financial statements to understand the health, operations, and many other things about the company.
Like a report card?
In a way. The simplest form of financial statements are comprised of three main statements.
Oh, I know these. My dad reads them all the time. It's the balance sheet, the income statement, and the cash flow statement.
Ethan, yes, those are the three main reports that make up the financial statements. I will caution that sometimes they have different names, such as the statement of operations instead of the income statement.
Well, that makes things more complicated.
Agreed, but I wouldn't worry about it. They all show the same thing. Now, if we really want to impress your dad, why don't we add one more that is also common?
Oh man, he would be so surprised. He would love it.
I sometimes question your dad's sanity.
Okay, so the other common report is the statement of equity. To make this easier, why don't I ask what your business has done so far, so we can use it as an example?
Sure. Well, first my dad gave us $200. Second, we bought this lemonade stand for $80. And third, we bought supplies for the lemonade for a price of $115. We ended up selling 100% of our lemonade today and got a total of $150.
Ooh, don't forget we also bought candy bars.
Oh yeah, we also bought candy bars for $5.
Well, great. Why don't we start with the balance sheet? Think of the balance sheet as a picture in time. This report tells you what a business has at any specific time. On the top, you have the assets, which are things you own and have claim to. On the bottom, you have your liabilities and equity, which represent things you owe to others or others have claims to.
Why do they call it a balance sheet?
Great question, Lisa. As the name implies, your balance sheet should balance. Your assets will equal your liabilities and equity. This is called the accounting equation. We typically see balance sheets broken out by whether items are current, meaning due or to be used in 1 year, and non-current.
Got it.
For example, cash is current because we can utilize it daily. However, this lemonade stand is non-current because it can be utilized over more than 1 year.
That makes sense, but would you mind showing us?
Sure, let's take a look at what your five activities would look like on a balance sheet.
First, we got $200.
Right, and this would be demonstrated by a debit to cash and a credit to equity. Notice how it still balances. Next is your purchase of the lemonade stand. This is demonstrated by a debit to property, plant, and equipment, or PP&E, and a credit to cash for $80, which reduces the balance. Notice how all these entries are a change within your assets, and the balance sheet still balances.
Yeah!
I see that. Let me guess the next one. We bought supplies, so that would be a debit to inventory for $115 and a credit to cash.
Yep, that's correct.
Okay, but what about all the other transactions?
Well, all your other transactions flow through the income statement, so let's take a look at that report first. The income statement shows the operations of a company over a specific period of time. You can think of it more like a story of what your company's operations did during this period.
Okay, so do we start with revenue of $150?
That's right. At the top, we start with revenue. Your entry would be a debit to cash, back on the balance sheet, and a credit to revenue. You will notice as the income statement changes, the equity account will also change to reflect the owner's equity earned.
But what about our costs?
Yeah, so the next item is cost directly related to the generation of revenue. This is called your cost of goods sold, or abbreviated to COGS. Your inventory was $115 and you used all of it. Therefore, this is a debit to COGS and a credit to inventory.
Okay, that makes sense.
Now, technically, we would book depreciation for your lemonade stand. However, let's keep that lesson for another day.
Sounds good.
Now, what about those candy bars? We could put them in selling, general, and administrative expenses, or SG&A. So we would debit SG&A and credit cash.
Wait, you can expense that?
Well, yeah. You used company funds, didn't you?
Oh yeah, I didn't think about that.
So that's it for your guys' transactions. You can see our net income is $30, which is the amount equity has increased on the balance sheet.
I see that. Everything balances.
Oh, one more thing. Don't forget your taxes.
What? Taxes?
Yeah, well, technically you should make a provision for those, but I won't tell the IRS if you won't tell.
Okay, Fitz, what about the cash flow statement? Our net cash is $150.
Yep, I saw that on the balance sheet. So the cash flow statement is also like a story with a beginning and an ending. This report demonstrates the cash flows your company had over a period of time. We break this statement into three types of cash flows. Those types are operating cash flows, or the cash flows generated by the operations of the company, investing cash flows, or the cash flows for investing in the company's operations, or lastly, we have financing cash flows. These are the equity and debt cash flows from the period.
Those seem easy enough to remember.
Yeah, not too hard. So let's do an example with your operations. Your operating cash flows will start with net income. Now your financials are pretty easy right now, but as you have more items, they will need to be increases and decreases for things like depreciation, a non-cash activity, or the change in your balance of your inventory.
Okay, but for now operating is the $30.
Yep. Now your investing cash flows were a decrease for what you paid for the lemonade stand, so that's a negative $80. Lastly, your financing is the money from your dad, so that's a positive $200.
Oh, I see, and the net of those three is $150, which agrees to our balance sheet cash account. I also see that it shows our starting point of $0 and our new balance of $150 showing the change over that period.
Yep, great, you got it.
So those are the three main reports of the financial statements?
Yep.
Okay, let's do the extra credit to impress my dad. What's the statement of equity?
Yeah, let's go through that. The statement of equity is also like a story. It shows the changes in equity over the period. It starts at the beginning of the period, has the activity for the period, and ends with the closing balance of equity.
And it will agree to the balance sheet amount?
Yep, that's correct. Let's go through an example of your first day.
So we started with zero equity, so that would be our starting point.
Yeah, and then your dad gave us $200.
This can be presented lots of different ways, but let's keep it simple and call it the additional paid in capital.
But what else? We still don't equal the balance sheet of $230.
Yeah, this is because we need to show the income generated during the period of $30.
Ah, gotcha. That makes sense. Now it ends with the equity on the balance sheet. Plus, my dad can see his investment balance.
Well, thanks so much, Fitz. And you too, FIFO.
I can't wait to see how impressed my dad is. We sure learned a lot about the basics of financial statements.
Great. Good luck with the business, kids. All right, folks, thanks so much for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. And if you can, donate to Patreon. Anything you can give helps to keep the lights on and ensures we can continue to create content. And of course, helps feed FIFO. If you want to contact us about anything you saw in this video, accounting advice, or ideas for future videos, contact us at patreon.com/accountingacademy.
This video is designed to be illustrative and does not represent an official position. We make no representations, warranties, or guarantees and assume no responsibility for the application of this material. Please seek advice from a competent professional if expert assistance is required.